It's no secret that everyone who walks into the NBA will one day walk away washed up, or in kinder ways to put it, a shell of their former selves. We've seen it with the great Michael Jordan during his Washington stint, and we'll see it one day with the fresh faces that walk into the NBA. A player becomes washed up for many reasons. It can be their lack of desire to play the game, off-court antics, injuries, and most typically, age. It's a hard thing to watch, but it's harder to watch when it's an all-NBA talent, as we're accustomed to seeing these players play at a certain level and dominate the game. In this video, we're going to be looking at stars that dominated the league just a few seasons back and now look washed up. And guys, before we get started, don't forget to subscribe and like the video. The channel is really growing right now, and the likes really push the video out, so join the community. With that being said, let's get into the video. The first player we'll be talking about is Blake Griffin. Griffin, during his prime, was one of the most entertaining players in the league, always bedazzling the crowd with his impressive leaping abilities and thunderous dunks. But his game went further than that, and as the years progressed, he expanded his game, adding a jump shot coupled with playmaking and ball handling abilities. At his height, he finished third in MVP voting. Nowadays though, it actually hurts to watch Blake Griffin play. That athleticism that was once so freakish and his biggest advantage over players is now non-existent, and the abilities that he expanded over the years don't look so good. His production has really fell off a cliff, and it's a culmination of multiple reasons. Blake has always been really injury prone throughout his career, and it got in the way of the Clippers' playoff runs from time to time. But he always was able to maintain this high level of play, and it even continued in Detroit when he ended his 3-year drought period from the All-Star game with them. The following season though, which is the 2019-2020 season, Griffin only played 18 games, undergoing 2 knee surgeries on his left knee. And now, the former All-Star looks more like a serviceable role player. He's currently averaging only 12 points and shooting 36% from the field. In his career, that percentage was at a near 50% while contributing over 21 points to his team. He's become this not so athletic spot up shooter. And you know what? Shooting was never his game. Blake is also playing with the Pistons, so the situation isn't going to get better. He has no motivation to really play hard because the team is not very good. And it's not like if he plays hard and shows teams he still has stuff in the tank, they'll trade for him, because he has one of the worst contracts in the NBA. Next we have is Kevin Love. To Timberwolves fans, Love was the second coming of Kevin Garnett, a power forward who was relentless on the boards and could score in a variety of ways, from working in the block to shooting from outside. His years in Minnesota saw him put up absurd stats, like 30-30 games. But if you know the Timberwolves organization, it never truly translated to winning basketball, as the team, like so many years prior, and even now, failed to surround their star player with talent. So he was shipped off to the Cavs, where he had to adapt his game to LeBron and become more of a perimeter player. Love was still an All-Star despite changing his whole game, playing an integral role in the Cavs making 4 straight NBA Finals. And as LeBron left for the Lakers, the Cavs decided to give their only running All-Star a massive $120 million contract in the offseason. Love has not been able to get back to his All-Star form since signing this contract. He's really struggling to stay on the court, only playing 80 games since inking the deal. When he has played, it's been very poor. Age and injuries have really taken a toll on him. He can't rebound like he used to. He can still shoot at a respectable level, but his defense and athleticism is non-existent. It's a net negative to play him on the court. And the hard truth is, the other bigs on the team, though can't shoot like him, offer other services that make them more serviceable to play, like Drummond, Nance, and Allen. This season, he's averaging 9.5 points and 6 boards while shooting 33% from the field. It's a small sample size, but it's clear the league has really moved away from him, and he's not the same All-Star player he used to be. DeMarcus Cousins is the next player on this list, and his demise was very unexpected. It happened at the age of 27, when he was arguably the best big man in the league for 3 to 4 years. He tore his Achilles going for a rebound, and it changed the very trajectory of his career. And now, at the age of 30, what is supposed to be the prime years of an NBA player, he has been reduced to being a backup center. To top it off, he didn't even get his money. At his height, he was averaging about 27, 11, and 5. He was able to do everything you could ask for in a big. He could shoot from outside, create for his teammates, hit free throws, play in the post, and defend. But as the injuries came on, parts of his game started to be taken away. The ruptured Achilles, torn quad, torn ACL has affected every part of his game, from shooting to getting down on the block and putting in work. Right now, he's averaging 9 points and 7.5 boards on an abysmal 35% shooting from the field. That's over 11% decrease from his career, so I think it's safe to say he's washed up now. Kemba Walker. Many of you guys probably think I put him on this list too early. After all, he was an all-star just last season and is coming back from an extended absence, which could possibly explain his very poor start to the season. I think there is some truth to that, and he will get better with more games under his belt. But I also think Kemba will not return to his all-star form. What made Kemba an all-star all these past seasons was his uncanny ability to put the ball in the basket. He wasn't really able to excel at much else, with him being such an undersized guard. He can't defend, can't rebound, and his playmaking is just alright. What made him great is his scoring abilities. The problem is, it has taken a severe hit due to the trouble he's experiencing with his left knee. He's not moving as quick, is struggling to make fast stops, and just can't create enough space between him and his defender. During his game with the Jazz, he missed 10 of his 12 shots, where he had a couple of air balls and 4 of his shots were blocked. This knee issue is also not going to get much better, as it's chronic. And the hard truth is, Kemba is now north of 30, and the Celtics also don't need him, as Tatum and Brown have emerged as stellar and better scorers. So what is Kemba really providing now? His All-Star days are clearly behind him. Next is Paul Millsap. It's hard to put him on this list, as he's honestly aged so gracefully. He's 36, playing a starting role for a team that made the Western Conference Finals last season. But the truth of the matter is, even though Millsap is more than a serviceable role player in this league, he's not the four-time All-Star that carried the Hawks to deep playoff runs anymore. In his prime, he was one of the most sought-out two-way power forward, able to play great team defense and lock up his opponent, and score the ball in various facets. He never got the due and recognition he deserved from fans and media, but his peers knew him to be one of the top talents in the league. When he moved to Denver, we all knew it was the start of his declining process and he wouldn't be an all-star anymore, like the season prior. His minutes there declined steadily as well as his production, but he really did what they asked for, defend at a high level and shoot the ball lights out. He's shooting 41% from 3 there right now, but his defensive ability has slipped. He's no longer racking up defensive stats like he did during his peak years. Millsap is still more than a serviceable player, but he's washed up compared to his all-star days. Next, we have his LaMarcus Aldridge. Aldridge always had this old man game to him, where he didn't rely on his athleticism so heavily, but his finesse and skill set. He never got his true recognition from fans for being such a great power forward, but he did quietly put up a stellar basketball resume together, racking up 7 All-Star appearances in his career, with the last one being in the 2019 season. He's still an effective player in this league, as he is a power forward who developed an outside shot, and his face-up and mid-range game is still great, averaging a very respectable 14-4 while shooting 48% from the field. But father time is definitely showing, and he's not that all-star caliber talent anymore. It's just going to get worse with time, especially with the Spurs going on a youth movement. Aldridge's minutes will be cut, and soon he will be moved to the bench. Yes, he can still play meaningful minutes on a championship team off the bench, but he's not that dominant player we've seen on the Trailblazers and early years on the Spurs. Last we got is Carmelo Anthony. What can we say about him? One of the greatest scorers the game has ever seen. His career though is very difficult to put into words. The teams he played for the most part, underachieved. Carmelo is still one of the greatest small forwards of all time, a player who had everything in his scoring arsenal, from a low post game to shooting from deep. In his career, he racked up 10 All-Star appearances, with the last one being in 2017. He's still able to give you solid minutes off the bench, and some nights can go for a scoring outburst, but realistically, he's a shell of his former self. Once a player who collected scoring titles, now averaging 12.5 points on 38% shooting from the field. Great for a 36-year-old, but far from what we saw him do for 14 plus years in the NBA. That's all we got for today. In the comments, tell us a player that we missed. This is Earn Your Ranks, where we only talk about ball. Signing off.